gals, today we are going to talk about pens that are waterproof. And this is specifically for watercolor artists. So for the majority of my watercolor art, and I'm grabbing an example right now, for the majority of my watercolor illustration, I use either the Sailor Mitsuo Aida, which you guys have heard me talk about before many, many times, or the Sakura of America Pigma BB. That's a calligrapher, Pigma BB, MB, and FB. But let's talk about some other waterproof, watercolor accessible pens. So these are all pens that have been vetted by me or recommended by a friend and then cross-checked by me. We have I believe it is the Sailor Ryofuka. And this is pretty much like the Sailor Mitsuo Aida, except it's, you know, a different calligrapher that they have partnered with. So it uses, or it seems to use, the same formulation that is in the Mitsuo Aida. It's just in a slightly more ergonomical pen body. And I think it looks pretty snazzy with those gold speckles in there. You've got this particular zebra, which was recommended to me by Heidi Black, and I actually don't know the exact name of it, but I will get that for you guys and list it in the description, along with the inks. You've got pretty much any of the Sakura of America Pigma products, so the Pigma Sensei, the Calligrapher, the Pigma MB. You've also got the Microns, which have Pigma on them, the Pigma graphic liner. So any of the Pigma line by Sakura of America is going to be waterproof. You can watercolor on top of it. You can also Copic marker on top of it. You can do the same with the Sailor Mitsuo Aida. Then we have they call these art marker or illustration markers, but they're really fine liners. The Prismacolor colored fine liners are waterproof. And they're available. You can get a brush tip. You can also get them in 0.8 and I believe 0.5. And then Copic also makes a wide variety of colored fine multi-liners. So we've got, I think I'm only missing sepia, and I actually have a sepia pack somewhere. But we've got lavender, sakura, light gray, a burgundy, a dark blue, and black. So these are all pigment inks, and pigment inks are going to be waterproof and Copic marker proof. There's also a variety of fountain pen inks on the market that are pigment based. You can check out my fountain pen channel playlist for some of those. I'm still working my way through testing them all. And then you have the Copic Multiliner SPs, which are just a nicer version of the Copic Multiliners. So pretty much any pigment-based ink is going to be suitable for your watercolors. Acrylic inks, once they've had a chance to dry, will be suitable for your watercolors. I find that Sumi inks, India inks, and the Kaimei Sol K ink, those are very hit or miss. Even if I give them a really long dry time, up to 2 weeks even, they will still reactivate sometimes if I add water, if I let water sit on them, if I do heavy washes, if I do a lot of scrubbing. So those are sort of your mileage may vary, but Winsor & Newton makes pretty decent India inks. I believe they have a waterproof one that will work well if you enjoy using brushes. You can also, like I said, use acrylic inks, but you want to make sure you clean that out of your brush completely because acrylic will ruin your brushes eventually. And I think that is a pretty good basic overview of waterproof. These are waterproof pens, so these are a little bit easier to use, a little more accessible, especially if this is like your first Inktober and you want to watercolor on top of it. These would be a really good way to go. I'm a huge fan of brush pens because I like the sort of bouncy line weights you can get from them. So these are going to be my go-tos. I don't know about this Inktober, but this is what I use in general, is brush pens. And I have a bunch of brush pen reviews in my brush pen section at nattosoup.blogspot.com. So if you're interested in a specific brand, head on over there and see if I've reviewed it. I've reviewed a bunch of Japanese brands. And I may pick that up again, but I think I've reviewed over 20, and that is an exhausting number to review. So I hope you guys found this helpful. I hope you found it useful. I hope it will help you in your watercolor endeavors, and I hope you guys have a great day. I hope to see you again really soon. Bye, guys.